Con, so we're really freaking out. You guys having fun?
Yeah!
We're so excited here. We've got an entire female panel here today to do a big reveal that we have with Mattel. You guys seen any of it yet? Why don't we get this party started here? Please welcome up Mattel Senior Vice President and GM for the Girls Toy Box, the woman who is solely responsible here for the astonishing detail to these fashion dolls. Please welcome Lori Mattel from Mattel.
Christmas tree, Mom. It's amazing, so thank you guys.
history here in WWE, having Money in the Bank ladder matches twice, Hell in a Cell matches, Falls Count Anywhere matches. Do you guys ever get a chance to actually sit there and just reflect on what you've actually done and what you've been able to accomplish, like, in that moment?
Sometimes. And there is another moment where you're like, okay, now we've got a line of dolls. Like, it's unbelievable. I remember there was one time at WrestleMania 32, and it was just before we had the triple threat. And to be able to have such a marquee match and where we were able to bring in the new women's belt. And I remember sitting at Whole Foods, and I just started crying, like just bawling, like, it's, what's wrong with that weird orange-haired girl? But it was like, you know, when I started at 15, this didn't seem possible. To have our, you know, heads on the side of AT&T Stadium just didn't seem possible, and to be able to perform in front of 100,000 people, and there was two women's matches on that card, and that was the first time that happened at a WrestleMania, and then we just keep going and we keep progressing, and making history is now the norm, that it's almost not a big deal, and that personally is where I wanted it to get to, and I think all these other women, is that we've worked and we've been good, and we have created characters that hopefully you can identify with, or that you either hate or you love, but it makes you feel something. And to be able to do that, it's phenomenal. I don't know that it's all gonna hit me, maybe one day when I sit down and write, maybe in a Ralph's or something, I'll start crying.
And what else do you guys have in box? Already, are there things that you still want to knock off your bucket list, or things that you have in the future that you kind of want to take care of?
Main event WrestleMania?
Here, Breezy, I'm coming your way. What's up with that mom life?
Oh my gosh, you know, it's actually crazy because being a mom and now sitting and watching all these girls do amazing things every week, it's like I said, as a fan now. But I think being a mother, it's crazy because these dolls come out. And I have a daughter now, and I start thinking to myself, like, wow, these are role models. Like, these are people that now Birdie gets to look at and know what it means to be confident, what it means to be independent, where you don't need a Ken doll. And, it's so, it gives me goosebumps as I think to myself that one day I could explain to Birdie why I'm an action figure and why I'm a superstar doll. And it's because, you know, your mom was with a bunch of women and your dad decided to come together and just break barriers. And, you know, not listen to the answer no. We're like, no, we're going to turn that into yes. And all the negativity that was always around, like, short matches and what divas and women meant to WWE, we turned into a positive. Now look at it, you know, it's incredible. And so I think now as a mom, I sit back and it means way more to me, like, seeing everyone's accomplishments and what we've done. It's insane that I actually get to, you know, see my daughter one day be proud of all the women in WWE.
You're watching Raw, you're watching SmackDown, to not be in the ring, and you've transitioned to this other side of your life. How does that feel for you?
Well, it's hard not to be, like, envious. I, like, look at all the money. Dang, I would love to, like, jump off the ladder. But I'm breastfeeding and watching. And so, way different. But, you know, I think it's crazy. It's, like, over the envious, I'm so proud. Because I think of the woman who paved the road when, you know, I came. And Nikki and I, we had a long journey. And then to see, like, things we did, and then to see, like, these women still paving the road, and then, you know, the girls who are coming in the future because of NXT are going to pave it even longer. So it's like, you're crazy. I sit at home and I'm a little jealous and envious. I'd do anything to get in there and get it all remote, But I also sit back and I'm really proud because I'm like, wow, I feel a part of it still. But at the same time, I'm just like, wow, WWE's in really good hands, in women's hands.
Since we saw you get engaged in the middle of the ring at WrestleMania. What have you been up to? Do you have a date? Where's the wedding at? Give us some
reminder. I keep getting asked that question. We actually finally set a date, but I'm not going to say. Always in my heart. Yeah, that was insane, getting engaged in front of all you guys. I think my favorite part is watching it back and seeing John's voice get so shaky and just not be that super confident Cena. So I really liked that. But yeah, I'm just kind of, right now we're filming Total Divas Season 7, so we just picked up Season 7, which we're very excited about. And we just wrapped Total Bellas Season 2, so I'm just kind of doing the reality thing and waiting for my neck to heal because I see two girls on my right, two girls on my left, and I see my tag partner right here, and I'm kind of like, oh shoot, I want to get back. So, I know there's besties over here and besties over here. I'm like, do we sip tea or do we have and get the box? I don't know. But, yeah, right?
There's some women's tag team titles.
Ooh, see? Kind of hoping my neck heals, and I hope it heals quick.
Yeah, what's the status with your neck right now? Where are you at with it?
So we found out that it's not fully fused, and I kind of have a herniation above where I had surgery, but I think with time it could heal, hopefully, so I'm trying to do whatever I can.
So fair to say
we'll see you back in the
ring.
What?
Fair to say we'll see you back in the ring at some point.
I think so.
Yeah. Bree's coming back. You all see.
Like, how long does it take to give birth and then wrestle? How does that
work? 21 hours for her.
Yeah, 21 hours of labor. And I didn't have naturally. And then I was like, hell no.
Were you aware members in your audience may be under the age
of 18?
Oh, yeah, sorry. It's very good.
Birdie came out safe, and that's all that mattered to me. But it made just kind of getting ready to get back in the ring a little back. But my husband and I talked this week. We actually went kayaking in the bay. And he's like, you know what, Bree? I think we have enough room to get a ring, and why don't we start training? And I was like, yes! I've been begging him for one. So I'm like, I have the perfect coach, general manager. Thank you, Daniel Bryan. But we're going to start training. I'm hoping 2018 I can get back in the ring.
The brand shake-up, you went from Raw over to SmackDown Live. What's been the big difference from you transitioning between the two different brands?
Well, I remember being on Raw thinking, I want to be better than SmackDown. And then now I'm on SmackDown going, I want to be better than Raw. But I think the biggest difference...
Yeah, I said it.
I think just new competition and a new group of women, a new group of men and the superstars and wanting to, and it automatically creates competition. And I think that's healthy. And, you know, winning that SmackDown Women's Championship to become the first ever Triple Crown winner.
You've been in so many historic matches, and we've seen you just break down barrier after barrier. Is there a certain match that sticks out the most to you that was most important as far as making history in WWE?
That's hard. I think WrestleMania 32. I just remember being in Gorilla looking at Sasha and Becky and thinking they were living their dream and they'd wanted this their entire life. And then me being a part of it and knowing that I was continuing my dad's legacy. We had spent I get goosebumps thinking about it. But he had spent, you know, 40 years creating this amazing legacy, and that I was continuing it that night. And to think in 2007, I was sitting front row watching his career come to an end, and never thinking that this was an option or a possibility, or that I was going to be a women's wrestler one day. And there, you know, seven or however many years later, I was walking the same aisle as my dad, and with him beside me, I was like, "Dad, don't take the spotlight tonight, please." It's crazy. So I think that night will probably be, you know, the most memorable of my career, and especially the debut of the Women's Championship, showing that the company was investing that much into us at the time, and look what it's become. I mean, look how many women are here today, and it's not the men, the women are representing WWE, and that says a lot.
Sure, we're there in Brooklyn when Stephanie McMahon had revealed that championship belt. I mean, that was such a crazy moment for everybody out there. So it's cool to see where you guys have gone. Yeah, just the investment of having Raw and SmackDown out there. And so, Becky, coming to you now. On Instagram, we see you training, doing CrossFit all the time. How does that help you in the ring?
I think it's helped a lot, because I feel like it's probably the thing that simulates what we do the most, you know what I mean? Because you can be on a treadmill or whatever, but nothing gets your heart rate like that, you know, with burpees and jumping up and down and throwing weights over your head and everything, which is what we do in the ring. Like, we're dropping down and I'm throwing Charlotte over my head and over my shoulder. And or she's throwing me. Yeah, we know. So I think that's really helped. And the other thing that I love about it is the sense of community. So in WWE, we have a certain amount of talent and the staff that do CrossFit. Faye is one of them. And we have, yes you are, yes you are. So right now, what we have is an internal competition. So everybody here, by the way, if anybody does CrossFit, y'all can follow along. We're calling it the Summer Open, and we're gonna have 5 weeks of challenges. And this, or today actually, the first workout came out, and it is horrendous, horrendous. But they call me Cybex because I'm a machine, so.
If it wasn't for James Ellsworth interfering in the Money in the Bank ladder match, you could have been sitting here as this Money in the Bank. Do you think that there's any chance that we might be able to get to see you beat up James Ellsworth one day?
I don't know. What do y'all think about that? Would anybody like to see that match?
Yes!
Maybe can you ask your husband? Do us a favor. I would love that. I would love that. And I don't see why not right now. I mean, he's in the women's division pretty much. I don't see a reason why I can't get my hands on him.
I'm sure we can start some kind of petition online. You guys are pretty good at that, right?
Bonus time is just around the corner. Let's have it.
Amazing in-ring gear. How do you come up with your designs? How do you kind of get it from paper to on your bod?
Of
course, thanks to my wonderful husband.
And you always wanted to be different, flashy and blingy, and I just told my husband, like, make you look the best, please, honey, or else they're okay when you get home. And he really just chooses everything. Unless it's like something really important, like WrestleMania 32, when I had my Eddie Guerrero gear. Thank you. There's some gear that really to me, or like Pink and Yellow, which was my first ever ring gear in the Indies. And then I bring it to Monday Night Raw or my big pay-per-views, and it always means something to me. Sasha, your rivalry that you have with Charlotte was one of the most amazing rivalries that we've ever seen here at WWE, which is why you're at separate ends of the table. Is there somebody, a superstar past or current, that you think that you could get in the ring and kind of make some more magic like that with?
Past or current?
Whatever you follow, whichever one you want.
I think I would have to choose. Oh, there's so many women. I don't know. That's so hard.
Of course, me and Charlotte have done it all. We really have gone at it. Of course, Bailey. I've been in the ring with all these women, so I'll say all of you guys. Let's do it all again.
Yes.
And Bailey, I'm coming to you now. You, of all the women up here, you spent the most time down in NXT, obviously working in some amazing time. I don't think that is a word, I just mean timeline. Why are you so funny? It was in the script! In the script.
I got all these questions, huh?
Not me. But just, the stuff you did down in NXT, how much is the roster different from being down in NXT or being up in the main roster? Even the fan base, how different they are.
You mean NXT roster now, or?
Yeah, just from like when you were down at NXT and moving up to the main roster, and then just looking at the fan bases between the two.
The roster is kind of similar. Like everybody, like you said, I was the last one there. So when I got to WWE, everybody was there already. So it was kind of just a bigger version of NXT. Luckily, I was, you know, I kind of knew the fellas would come down and Natty would come down and Fox and stuff to NXT and kind of helped us get NXT on its feet when it first started, so I kind of knew the girls and knew everybody by the time I got there. But the fan base is so different, and it's kind of good, it's kind of bad. Like NXT is more of a smaller community, I guess. I like to compare it to like a family, because NXT fans really saw us from the ground up, and they watched us all grow. They all saw my first match ever in NXT. They all saw their first matches in NXT, so they watched us grow and watched us make it to WWE, so they kind of know us. I don't know, I like to think they're like family. And there's smaller crowds, obviously, when we travel to shows and stuff, and NXT is only like once a month film, so now we're like live every Monday on Raw, and that's
and on a more positive note, because you are a total badass, we go back to WrestleMania this past year, and you outlasted everybody to retain the Raw Women's Championship. What do you plan on doing? Like, what else could top that for you, like that moment of you having your first WrestleMania match?
Once I got past the entrance, when I slipped on the that's a good start. I didn't think I would end up winning that match. I was like, oh no, this is bad. I'm not ready. So next WrestleMania, when I have an entrance, I'm not gonna slip. And I hope, I like when everybody's involved in everything, but I'd really like to just have a singles match. You know, like I'm a little selfish in that, but I'd like to have a singles match at WrestleMania 1 minute. In Orlando, so I had my NXT family there, and to be in the ring with Sasha and Charlotte, who I, you know, came up with, was just, I couldn't have asked for a better match.
Round of applause. And this is a big week for you, Bailey. Not only do you get your own fashion doll, but you also got some gummy bears too, right?
Oh yeah, I need to bring them out here. FYE. I got Bailey gummy bears. It's incredible. I left them in the back, but if you guys go to FYE, buy some gummy bears and some bootios and some t-shirts, and send, give them to your friends.
They're 100 calories per 13.
Yeah. Only 13 a day, guys. 100 calories.
All right, so now we're going to open up the floor to you guys. We've got a microphone to the back there. Be nice to each other. Don't leave anyone in line. And we'll start taking your questions.
What is the craziest thing that happened backstage?
Okay.
time.
Yeah. What? I'm trying to get a job, so hang on. Actually, something crazy I'll never forget, when my husband, Dana Bryan, was wrestling Randy Orton, and he got a stinger, so they cut it, like, they stopped his match, and he was very confused, and it was live on Raw. So he came back, and, you know, I was in there, and we all were like, oh, he has a concussion. He comes back and he's like, who stopped my match? And it's like, I did. And he's like, why? And I'm like, no, Brian, no. Stinger, no. And I'm like trying to not, but it was pretty crazy. I was like, I've never seen so much passion with my husband. And then, you know, but everyone was cool because they're like,
he was screaming at everyone and cussing. And Bree's trying to stop him, but I'm like in the back of the popcorn, like, yes. I've never heard him cuss before, so I was like, oh my gosh. Great, but like he was scary with the beard and the long hair.
Yeah, everyone was like, "Note to self, don't cut Daniel Bryan's beard."
This was TLC when my dad was my manager, and in the match he actually thought I really got hurt, but he was a very important piece in the what was gonna happen at the end. So instead of taking off the turnbuckle, he was like at my feet going, honey, are you okay? I'm like, dad, I'm fine. You're supposed to be taking off the turnbuckle. You're about to ruin the entire end of the match. He was like, oh, I'm sorry. And sometimes he would just woo randomly. Well, the match wouldn't have ended up how it was supposed to end up. So the amount of stress and gray hair he gave me that first year, you have no idea.
I have to say Charlotte and Rick are extremely entertaining backstage. I mean, imagine taking that
death. The struggle.
Right?
There's a lot of stories about all the ladies up here. But yeah, that's the craziest. She had to kiss him, so I'm sure that was
stop calling me sis.
Under 18.
Hi there, my name is Hank Romero. I'm with the Wrestling with Reality podcast. My question is for all the superstars on stage, and this includes Renee as well. What is the best veteran advice you have received that has forever changed your work as a performer for the better? Who gave it to you, and also are any of you related to Kurt Angle?
So I got the best advice from Rey Mysterio when I first got in the business, and Rey told me, because I was so nervous for my debut. I wanted to vomit. I just felt like I couldn't see straight. And Ray was like, honestly, the day you don't feel this is the day you shouldn't be in the business. He's like, every night when you wrestle, you should be walking out feeling this. And I was like, you know what? And it's true, every night. We all like are in gorilla, nervous, want to vomit. We want to perform perfect for all of you. And he's so right. It's like that feeling you'll always have. And if it does go away,
I've gotten so much praise, I remember that. I'd say it was my first match like up on the roster. It was a live event. And I'll never forget Scotty Armstrong, who was a referee at the time, who's now a producer. It was like, breathe, baby girl. And I was like, yeah, this works. Okay, it's great. And I'm like, still, 10 years later, we look at each other, breathe, baby girl. And I'm like, yeah, I got it. So yeah, that's one of the most
she's from Dusty, and he would just always tell me, just be you, baby. Just be you. I'll always take that with me.
My trainer back home, Jason Styles, said he actually learned it from Mae Young, who's
same thing was too. The day that you are not nervous is the day that you should leave. So every day, right before we go out, like, why am I doing this to myself? Putting all this stress and all, yeah, why do I do this? And then I come back after and I'm like, oh, that's why. One of the most important moments when you, I guess, come out for the match is right when you walk through the curtain. And for me, I think, because I'm always so nervous, like, and I'm in Gorilla before I go out, I'm like, why do I do this? I'm so nervous, I feel sick. Every Tuesday, regardless of this, it never gets old, but it's knowing who you are when you walk through that curtain, knowing your character, know what you represent, and know what you want the fans to feel. And you control that the second you come out through the curtain. So it's just believing and knowing who you are, is what I was told, and that has always stuck with me.
Woo! William Regal always tells me that it's like riding a wave. It's like surfing. So you know, you just gotta be on the wave. You just gotta go with it. Because sometimes you're down, sometimes you're up, but it. You know, there's always going to be more waves, so you're going to get a ride one.
Actually, it is from John Cena. But he's always told me, and I literally do ask myself when I wrestle, I can ask myself this again, is why are you fighting? And I feel like that's always been the best question. And even if you all watch Glow, like when the girl said it, like, wait, why are we fighting? We have a story. But then she wanted to fight over bread and do some Gone with the Wind type thing. But I thought I was like, wow, it's so true. I feel like it makes everything better. Why are we fighting? And so that's something that's always said.
I guess I just want to leave from Dean Ambrose. I mean, he gave me advice. Just like, you know who you are, you know what brought you here to do this, to be good at what you do. It's like, it's really just staying true to why you got into doing something and keeping that love for it and kind of just living in that element and being present with it.
Yeah. It's a match that each of you had to train and practice the most because of how intense and potentially dangerous the spots were.
Mine was the Iron Woman because it was 30 long minutes. Yeah.
I'm just saying, a lot of cardio ready for that match.
Yeah. Mine would be when I went against Stephanie McMahon and was like, don't hurt the box.
I actually would have to say mine would be Hell in a Cell against the girl to my right, Charlotte, because I knew that there was something severely wrong with my neck. So I had to, it was just a totally different mental game for me going into that match, and also wanting to be impressive because I was in a Charlotte Flair, and so that was definitely mentally and physically the most preparation I've ever had.
Oh man.
Yeah. I guess in terms of being prepared, obviously, there's just so many. I don't know, but I think of my NXT match where I won the NXT title versus Natalya was probably the match that I had to prepare the most for because, one, I wasn't sure I was ready for the position, and two, I hadn't been wrestling that long, and I wanted to show the world that I was more than just my last name. And I was just literally scared. So it wasn't as much preparing as for the moves of, oh, can I do a moonsault? It was just mentally psyching myself up to know that I could do this and that I wanted to be remembered and make a name for myself. So I think that NXT match is probably one of the most important ones in my career.
Oh, yeah.
So maybe I'm just thinking in terms of So, like the ladder match, for example. So it's a matter of like handling these ladders, and because you know we've got smaller hands and things like that than the guys, and they're heavy and they weigh a lot. So it's just a matter of trying to figure out how to maneuver them, and then even the tables match, like trying to figure out, you know, pulling out of the ring, because all these things weigh a lot. So I think it's those kind of matches that I really have to go in and like figure out the apparatus.
The history-making women's champion Alexa Bliss, a two-ring champion. Also, Carmella, the rightful next women's champion, Carmella Ann. Charlotte and Becky Lynch, the lovely Lana, so we're all done.
I'm gonna turn heel real quick. Because I've been baby for like 3 minutes.
Secret to really smart marketing and really smart business is keeping people waiting.
I'm Brian from Vancouver, British Columbia, and I'm training with Lance Storm in a month and a half, and I was wondering, do you have any advice for the kids that would want to grow up to be wrestlers one day, and what steps would they have to take?
Just Lance Storm.
Believe in yourself. If you don't believe in yourself, nobody else will. That was another bit of advice that was given to me, and it was awesome, and it's just about hard work, it's about dedication and passion. And I think those are the three ingredients that will take you to the moon and back. Because if you have that, then there's nothing that can stop you. Heck, I failed PE and I'm sitting here. If I can do it, anybody can do it. It's just about putting in the hard work and just doing it. And you've got a great teacher.
And I think too, like, you're gonna have so many times where you're gonna wanna give up, and it's just gonna be really hard, and you're gonna hear negativity from people, or you're gonna feel really bad about yourself, and it's like getting through those moments and be like, no, actually I can do this, there's a reason why I'm here, and it's not giving up. No.
Never give up, Greg!
Shirt that you're wearing when you got down on Wendy at WrestleMania.
Tag with your sister at WrestleMania against Paige and AJ.
Oh. Well, if we won, it would definitely be Brooklyn.
Learned so much, but it would have to be going against Stephanie at SummerSlam.
Can I have two? So one of them is WrestleMania 32, being able to be in the ring with Sasha and Charlotte and then unveil the Women's Championship and then winning the first ever SmackDown Women's Championship was awesome.
You hit your friends harder.
Your sister.
Thank you so much.